Zero Discrimination Day serves as an opportunity to highlight how everyone can contribute to the transformation towards a more fair and just society for people living with HIV and AIDS. According to HIV activists, discrimination against people living with HIV and AIDS in the country continues to persist, particularly through the emerging trend of online-based stigma and discrimination.
We should be informed that the Ministry of Health recently launched a national policy guideline on ending HIV stigma and discrimination. This was in 2023, last year, for enabling a legal and policy environment to end HIV and AIDS as a public health threat in the country by 2030. There is need, therefore, to continue to enforce these policies to ensure the protection of rights of persons living with HIV.
At the start of the year, we were drawn to a very terrible incident that was making rounds on TikTok of a mother that was being forced to confess to having HIV so that she could get a 10,000. Mm-hmm. How disheartening. And someone chooses to record that kind of would-be private conversation, I should say, and decides to run it around on social media on TikTok, which is like the most trending app, I think, now. So you can imagine the damage that caused around the woman, the damage it causes around her family, her children if she's a mother, and definitely the entire PLHIV community.
It's estimated that 33% of persons living with HIV and AIDS in the country have ever experienced some form of stigma and discrimination.
So many people don't want to disclose to these young people. They end up probably having sexual intercourse with them, yet they're HIV positive, and they end up getting what? Infected. So what is the status quo of stigma and discrimination among young people? When you look at these numbers, literally you can tell that we still have a lot of work to do. You can tell that indeed a lot has been done, but a lot more needs to be done.
According to the Uganda AIDS Commission, the country's HIV prevalence rate is 5.8%, and approximately 1.4 million persons are living with HIV and AIDS. The Minister of Health recently launched national policy guidelines on ending HIV stigma and discrimination. The HIV activists insist that such policies should be enforced to ensure the protection of the rights of persons living with HIV and AIDS. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.